Hi, sorry for the delay in starting, but there's a little technical problem. I think somebody in the building pulled out a network cable that I used to play the violin. The project is called The Sound of Gesture. And what I'm interested in for this particular set of pieces is focusing on the gestures that a musician uses to make sound. And a string instrument is a particularly useful instrument because we do things like accelerate and use speed and pressure and different types of angles in order to make the sound. And what I might do before each piece is just show you a bit about the senses I'm using for each piece. And when I was talking a little earlier, Paul de Lusingen made a very good point. He's an organ player who's here in the audience. Why am I using senses and not just audio? And actually, one would prefer to use audio as a controller because that's a basic musical medium. But because audio takes a long time to analyze, we can't really do that, use that as a controller in real time, except for volume, which I'm using, which we call envelope volume, which I'm going to use in one piece. So senses are really, although they don't make the sound in terms of physics, they do make the sound in terms of gesture. So in terms of computer control, it's easier to analyze, much easier and more reliable to analyze a gesture than a sound. That's as long as the computer network doesn't go down. So in this first piece, most of the pieces are compositions, but the first piece is more of an improvisation. I've divided the bow into two parts so that my upper part of the bow is controlling a different computer transformation to the lower part of the bow. And the two transformations I'm using for the musicians among us are granular synthesis, which is a very common synthesis technique that Ligeti probably invented, where you record a tiny part of the sound, and then it's fragmented into tiny grains, and then we can realign those grains. And it's a bit like a kind of snowflake effect with the sound. And what I'm doing with the various axes of my gestures, I'm either randomizing those or making the grains of sound longer or shorter. And then in the top part of my bow, I'm using an instrument that I call elbow resonator, and that's a series of delay lines. So the violin goes into a delay that delays the sound, and that provides a kind of echo effect. And it hasn't got a name because it's an improvisation.
Stevie, what sensor are you using to divide your bow?
Ah, yes. Thanks. Yes, this is very much a sort of talk concert, so I would love to answer any questions. Yes, I didn't say that very basic thing. I'm using gyroscopes and accelerometers. So gyroscopes measure rotation, and I've tailored them so that they're they're not this kind of motion. They're a rotation that I use to play the instrument. And I'm also using accelerometers, which measure the acceleration of my gestures. And I think that's all I'm using. Yes. And of course, the sound is always coming from the violin. I just said that there's nothing that's pre-recorded. So the sound source is the violin.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.